Hello students, welcome back to the course Automata Theory and Computability. In the last session, we discussed how to design the DFSM for different formal languages. In this section, we will see the second type of finite state machine, that is non-deterministic finite state machine. We can call it as a NDFSM. In NDFSM, there are 0, 1 or more than one transition for every combination of state and an input symbol. We can define the NDFSM by the formal definition through Winterpal. That is, M is equal to Q, sigma, delta, Q naught and F, where Q is the finite set of states, sigma is a finite set of input symbols called input alphabet, delta is a transition function. It takes two arguments, a state and an input symbol, but it returns a subset of our states. Next one is a Q naught. It belongs to Q, which is a start state. The last one is a final state, that is EF, is a set of final states. Okay. So next, now we'll see the one example for NDFSM, how it looks. Okay. See, this is what one example for NDFSM. Now, if we consider the state Q0, see in this case Q0, 0, it goes to how many states here? It goes to Q0 itself along with that Q1. This is here. I said no. So, from each combination of input symbol and a state, we can have more than one transition. But in the NDFSM, we had what? Only one transition. Okay. So, this is what the difference between DFSM and the NDFSM. Now, if we consider the state Q1, in this Q1, 1 is defined, but Q1, 0 is not defined. That means what? Only one transition is defined on this. But if we consider the Q2, see, for this, both transitions are not defined. So, therefore, what we can say, for NDFSMs, we can have 0, 1 and more than one transition. Now, we'll see how to represent this DFSM by using the formal, that is definition. Okay, that is what M is equal to Q. Q is what? Q0, Q1, Q2. Now sigma is equal to what? It is 0, 1. Delta as it is. Next one is Q0. Yeah, next one is Q2. Where delta is given by see here. Delta 0, 1. State is what? Q0, Q1, Q2. Okay, now Q0, 0. So Q0, 0, it goes to how many states? It goes to two states. Okay, therefore what we end all Q0, Q1. See, we are representing a set. Okay, this is what difference between DFSM and the NDFSM. But in that just a state. Okay, next Q0, 1, it goes to Q0. Clear? Yeah, next Q1, 0, it is not defined, that means it is not defined, null. Q1, 1, it goes to Q2. Next Q2, both are not defined, that is fine. And then mark the start state and the final state. Okay, this is what NDFSM. Okay, next we will see the extended transition function of NDFSM. Again, extended transition function, it is defined by the notation, that is delta cap. It takes the two arguments, a input symbol and the, that is input state and the input string, and it returns a subset of states. Okay, it is also defined by the recursive definition. The basis part says delta cap of q comma epsilon, which is equal to q. The induction part says, suppose W is equal to X into A, where A is the last symbol of W, and also suppose that delta cap of Q comma X, which gives some set of states, then union of, that is delta of pi comma ea, which is equal to r1 comma r2 and so on till rn. Then we can say delta cap of q comma w, which is equal to r1 into r2 into r3 and so on till rn. Now we'll take one example for this. Now if you consider the DFSM, sorry, NDFSM, that is Q0, Q1, Q2. Start 0, 1, 0, 1. By seeing this NDFSM, if you see Q0, 0, 0, 1, where it goes? Q0, 0, 0, 0, 1. The answer is what? Q2. Okay. So now we need to see, by using the extended transition function, we need to see whether we are getting the answer as Q2. Okay. So first what we need to apply? See here. So in this case, so we need to start with the basis part. What is the basis part? So we know that delta cap of Q, Q0 comma epsilon, which is equal to what it gives? It gives the Q0. Clear? Now, if we see the string, that is W is equal to 001, that is delta cap of, what is the first symbol in this case? It is 0. So delta cap of Q0 comma 0. Okay. Now in this case, you need to consider as what? X into A. Okay. X into A. Now in this case, what is that X? X is nothing but a epsilon. Okay. Epsilon into 0. A is nothing but a, that is 0. Therefore, we know that Q0 comma epsilon, in the previous set, we got answer as what? It is Q0. Okay. Therefore, what? The answer. So we need to take delta n of, it is what? Q0 comma last symbol is what? Is 0. Yeah, which is equal to what? If you see the delta of Q0 comma 0, it goes to Q0 comma Q1 answer. Now next what you need to consider? The Q0 comma 0 0. Now again what you need to consider? This one X into E. Now X is what? It is 0. So we already got the answer for that. What it is? Delta cap of Q0 comma 0 is what? It is Q0 comma Q1. Therefore, what you take? Delta N of Q0 comma last symbol is what? It is 0. Union delta N of Q1 comma 0. Now, delta N of Q0 comma 0 is what? It is Q0 comma Q1. Union delta N of Q1 comma 0, it is what? 5. Therefore, we will be having answer as Q0 comma Q1. Okay. Yeah, next one is what? Delta cap of Q0 comma 0 into 0 into 0. Again, what you take? X into E. X into E. So, delta cap of Q0 comma 0 0. What is the answer? It is Q0 comma 0 Q1. So, we need to take what? This one as what? Delta N of Q0 comma 0 union delta N of Q0 comma 1, sorry, Q1 comma 0. So delta N of Q0 comma 0 is what? It is Q0 comma Q1 union delta N of Q1 comma 0, it is what? 5, which is equal to, answer is again Q0 comma Q1. Yeah, next what we will take? Entire string. Delta cap of Q0 comma 0 0 0 into 1. So again what we need to consider? This one as X into E. X and E. Now we got the answer for what? Delta of, delta cap of Q0 comma 0 0 0. What is the answer? Q0 comma Q1. Therefore what you need to take? Delta N of Q0 comma 1 union delta N of Q1 comma 1. Now delta cap of Q1 comma Q0 comma 1, where it goes? It goes to, where it goes? It goes to Q0. Clear? Union delta n of what, q1 comma 1, where it goes? It goes to q2. Okay, therefore answer is what? q2 comma q0 comma q2. This is what answer. Just verify whether we are getting the answer as the same. So in this case here we will be getting see, just if you see the DFSM, what is answer for this? See here, 0, 0, 0, 1. That means we will be getting, first one is what, Q0. Next one is 0, 0, again 0, 0. That means it goes to Q2. So the answer is what? We need to get Q0, Q2. See, like this, we got what? Answer is Q0, Q2. Clear? This is what extended the transition function of NDFSM. Now we'll see, we'll take one question, how to design the NDFSM. Clear? So design a NDFSM for the language that accepts the set of all strings whose third symbol is 1. Okay, whose third symbol is 1. See, we know that the automata, it will read the input from what, left to right. Okay, so in this case we need to assume sigma is equal to 0 comma 1. Okay, we need to assume sigma is equal to 0 comma 1. So therefore, in this language, what is the minimum string? See, they said the third symbol is 1. Now, what is the meaning of this? So, we know that automata, it will read the input from left to right. So, from left, the third position is what? 1. That means what? 0 into 1. See here, from left. Or what? We can have what? Either 0, 1 into 1 we can have. Or what we can have, 101 we can have, or 111 we can have. These are what, some of the minimum strings. Clear, no? So now what, we need to design the NDFSM. So again what, Q0, Q1, Q2, this is what, Q3, start, Q0, 0, that is, yeah, we can have. See, first two positions we can have any, either we can have either 0 or 1. In the second position also we can have either 0 or 1, but in the third position we can have 1. So this is what the DFSM. Okay. Now see here, but fourth and fifth positions are, okay, now third symbol is what, 1, but after third symbol we can have what, either 0 or 1. Okay, so after third symbol we can have any number of zeros and 1, but mandatory is what, it is third position must be 1. So for example, say here we can have either 0, then what, 0, we can take 1, then what, 0, from this I'll take. So see here, third position is 1. This is what the NDFSM for the given question. Clear? Then what, you need to write the, by using what, a formal definition. Okay, you need to write the formal definition for this. What is the formal definition? M is equal to Q0, Q1, Q2, comma Q3. Then sigma is equal to 0, comma 1. Then delta as it is Q0, then Q3, where delta is given by, where, yeah, we can take delta 0 comma 1, 3 states, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, start state, final states. So Q0 comma 0, it goes to Q1, this is also Q1, Q1 comma 0, where it goes? Q2, this is also Q2, Q2 comma 0, where it goes, it is not defined, therefore it is 5, Q2 comma 1, it goes to Q3, so Q3 comma it is Q3, Q3. This is also Q3. This is what NDFSM. Thank you. Happy learning.